it is. There's the Nautilus we were talking about. This is what they need to stop this LeBlanc from being able to dash in nonstop.
I think this is much smarter. I think if you go Braum here, you really are just depending on winning early and playing sides because you have no ability to find
expect this early gank, and I don't think he's crashed top wave.
Exactly. Xiaohu is contesting the wave. That's what I was going to say. He's trying to fight aggressively into this wave to keep Adam there. Adam's trying to reset. Yeah, you are dead to rights.
No way for Adam to get out of this one. And First Blood goes over to RNG once again.
That really makes any sense. If you don't think you can pressure, there's no sense in going for it. If the chains lands, he might be dead.
Misky flashes away, Ming flashing in. There's the TP coming in from Adam as they look to try and take this fight. But once again, RNG with a great play. Ming will fall to Adam. Crying and Wei able to walk away.
Escorts Adam to the wave and Whipple gets Drake in the meanwhile, right? So it's a one-for-one trade in the end. Adam gets his wave and Whipple gets Drake. The bad thing is now is Nisqy has no
way. It's a nice move from RNG. Whipple, though, looking to get aggressive here.
Looking for Wei. Still has the flash on the Lee Sin. Smite's going to come down. Ignite is taking Whipple, flashing forward for the chase, and Whipple will take the kill. Fnatic find a skirmish.
And stay safe. And Nisqy now on the move.
Adam moved down from top to give Nisqy the push in mid, so Cryan can't contest. And now mid, Nisqy can move down towards the bot side. Wei actually has no camps on the bot side of the map right now. So if Whipple gets out,
we're going to get locked up here. Wei coming in. The attack with Hell Stun is there. Spectral more. They're trying to turn it back around. And there's the bullet time. And Gala will fall to Bean. And now Whipple's on the chase. RNG looks to try and catch out the jungler. But
Fnatic,
straight line. Wei might actually die again here.
Good ward. Rune Prison coming out. Wei should be able to walk out of this one. Still only level 5. Crying on the flank here. Whipple. Still no heartbreaker for him. And Whipple's so low already. And Crying with the burst damage. Wei now 6. Has the Dragon's Rage, Nisqy's gonna try and walk away, but the Sonic Wave connects, and it's a double for Wei.
Ah, it's just a little too far for Fnatic.
A lot of health to lose. RNG now with a health advantage at this fight. Gala on his way up. Hook's gonna come out. They're looking for Wei. They're trying to burst him before he can do anything, and there's the shutdown. Hilly low, Crying diving forward, but that's two over to Fnatic. The chase is on as Whipple tries to catch out this LeBlanc, who can try and turn it back around. Gala doing the damage in from the side, but it's a double for Nisqy. Crying, that's the clone medic.
Don't see Xiaohu actually going Ludens here. It looks like potentially. You know, Everfrost almost always.
Yeah, kind of auto build towards Everfrost, you expect, but
I'm so surprised to not see Kindle Gem as an early laning item, though.
Knockback from Xiaohu onto Adam. Wei just waiting around the corner, but Xiaohu's so low already, almost dies. Wei going in, Adam flashes away. Wei doesn't tank up the tower as of yet. Adam trying to turn this around, but Wei with the Sonic Wave combination. Adam with his clips, not enough to shield him up. Wei survives, Xiaohu survives.
As long as RNG stay top, there's no reason you couldn't get actually two charges here. Fnatic could potentially just move this forward, escort this in. They do get first power. Oh my god.
Wei's still here. Xiaohu is forcing Adam back. If Adam stays for longer, Whipple's on the way, yes, but he could be in danger again. He has no flash. One ultimate and he's dead.
Adam's dead. That was greed more than anything else from Adam.
I mean, trying to defend the tower.
Top's a weak side without vision. We're going to put wards down towards this bottom side of the map. And because of that, Adam can step too far forward. Ming can catch him out. The Magnet Storm comes out. Adam, no flash, no way out. And Ming will take the kill.
Yeah, playing weak side, Jace, really does feel like the map is in a terrible state. Because now Fnatic has to dive bot no matter what. Crying can match with TP, so it's probably a 2v3 because Whipple's not here. Looks like they're going to force it anyway.
Xiaohu tries to clear the wave. Hillisang with the hook bends it around the tower. Hillisang tanking this one up, but we'll have the heal and we'll have the shield. Xiaohu has to burn his flash to escape.
Yeah, I think Hillisang's hook hit a creep there or something, or one of the small crugs. They're going to force the tower anyway, but Crying has TP. Fnatic needs to be careful here.
Tower will fall. Hillisang still going forward. Bullet time available as Ming is locked up in. It will flash away. Hillisang taking with the Ignite Realm Warp coming out as well, as Nisqy's going to join this fight. Actually used to take them away. And Bean and Nisqy will escape, and Hillisang goes down.
Not the worst for Fnatic. They at least do get the tier 2. Does cost them the Hillisong's life, but they lose the tier 2 top, and Adam is just having incredibly difficult to deal with. Xiaohu, though, looking for a potential flank.
Whipple going forward, gets the stun onto Crying. Explosive cask available, will knock Bean back straight into the waiting arms a bit.
Oh, the Gale Force!
But the Gale Force will get them out, and now Bean's going to try and turn it around. Ming, locked up, taken out. The Gale Force
faces of Fnatic, who have found their form in week 2 here.
In the first game that everyone expected them to lose, Fnatic fighting is Hillisang locked down once again. Chains connect, Dragon taken by Fnatic, but RNG probably won't be done with this. They'll want the fight. Wei dives in, dives back, safeguards away. Crying chunked out, but that's the clone who goes low. Bullet time available here for Bean. Moonlight Vigil goes wide. Bullet time used to disengage.
Yeah, I think RNG might be able to get a mid-tier one off this. Fnatic's tempo is in
their gold lead. It will be in a slight one after this tower goes down, but still not too bad for Fnatic. Putting themselves to a potential early.
Always likes to make some plays from the support position. You can see RNG looking to make plays onto Hillisang. Chain's going to connect here, being in a good position for the bullet time if RNG do overextend. Wei still sitting on that Rift Herald with 50 seconds on. And Hillisan going forward, bullet time coming in, but Bean has been caught out. Xiao Hu was laying in wait, crying able to escape. Moonlight Vigil coming in as well as Quippo tries to put the damage down. Misty there as well. Adam joining the fight from the bottom side of the way is already dead as Quippo gets one reset. It's looking for two, but he can't quite get them. Ming able to get out alive.
Gala
just ripping through Fnatic right now. The Shuriken's doing so much work.
Yeah, he has the red and white guns. And Fnatic
so big for RNG. Not only do they get that gold, they stop that Mountain Soul from going with Fnatic's way.
Position like that, Adam now perhaps being caught out himself. Whippo is on the way up here, but Wei will have the Dragon's Rage, has the kick. Adam pushes forward. Wei jumps in with the safeguard. Crying jumps back. Hillisang and Whippo trying to get their TP coming in. Fnatic once again investing in to try and keep Adam alive. The fight's going to begin as Niski joins the fray. Wei caught out as well. Whippo looking for the damage there with the Heartbreaker, but can't quite get the reset. Xiao Hu going in. Wei dodges to the side of the overload, being now chasing forward. RNG, Ming caught out. 4v4 now in the top lane as Fnatic continue to advance. Wei low. Lands the smite, Whippo jumps across the wall. Fnatic might just turn back towards the Baron here.
Yeah, Fnatic was there in time to respond to Adam's push. He did buy enough time for them to arrive to force it into a 1v1. They have some control now, but Xiao is going in.
Bean has the bullet time. Xiao Hu looking for the engage. Bean now still on a ward. Xiao Hu though locked up, stopwatched. Is he going to stop time long enough? He can't. Shut down for Bean, and Fnatic get another kill.
Xiao Hu going to Hillisong. Yeah, they just start Baron. You can still look for the turn potentially on the way. Wei doesn't have smite. They don't know this, but RNG have really nothing they can do about it besides try to fight their way out.
Oh, oh, the hook! The bullet time, though, not quite enough. The Baron has not reset yet. Crying low. Baron down to 6,000. Adam coming in for the fight. Crying's going to back. He doesn't have TP to rejoin this way now. Still no smite on the Lee Sin. Do Fnatic. Do you stick a twist? Do you flip the coin? Do you flip the burger? Do you go for the fight? Baron down, down to 1,000. Whippo will secure it. Fnatic now looking for the fight as Adam's trying to distract all of RNG. Fnatic trying to get away. The Wormrobe will get two of them out. Hillisang sacrifices himself as well. So it will be only Whippo and Niski surviving with the Baron.
Yeah, triple kill. Over
1.7 for them at worst. So this has been back and forth, extremely close. And Fnatic still on soul point.
Magnus Storm coming in. They're looking to try and catch out Adam. And once again, it's Adam who is low. Wei's going to be able to kill him off. Adam will fall. Gala now dominating. And RNG with the Madden 4 making it out of the group. However, this year, it looked like they wouldn't be able to do it. It looked like with Bean, they just didn't have the metal, at least, show that they can challenge RNG.
Look at the ward behind Fnatic, though. Xiao Hu has TP coming up soon, and he's basing. If he TPs behind them right now, Adam's going to have to match their collapse. They're just going five.
It's feeling like it's going to be another Mountain Dragon going the way of RNG. And you have to wonder, you know, is this the right call? It's such a powerful buff there for Fnatic, but they're kind of saying they just don't have the setup for it.
Well, it's going to come in. TP's being invested. Xiao Hu flashes away, and Fnatic TPing away from the dragon. They just want this tower instead. They will get it. Their second tier 2 of the game.
Yeah, RNG are trading though, so yes, you got the top tier 2, but at best you're investing. Looks like they're going to force RNG out.
Oh,
really deep
right.
TP here, it's going to be a 5v5.
Yeah, Gala and Wei are caught out right now by themselves. TP's going to come in, they're looking for Wei, who has to try and flash away. Ming, no way to get into this fight. Wei pops a stopwatch out, who here? Gala and Crying going to join Ming off towards the top side. Niski trying to survive down towards the bottom. Hillisang low. Gala goes godlike, being locked up, and he's down as well. And now it's all on Adam, Whippo, and Niski to try and turn this one around, but Gala has the hula hoop of death. It falls off as Gala goes in. Whippo misses the Heartbreaker and it's double Xiao Hu. And the collapse is just too darn strong from RNG. Fnatic are thwarted.
Gala's just running over them. Adam falls again and Niski slated to fall here as well. The shutdown onto
the potential here to 100-0 someone like Bean who has no defensive itemization.
Really? He's looking for the hook, but the jump comes back. There's the chains and Hillisang already down to half HP. Fnatic still looking for the fight, but Gala pops the stopwatch. Spectral Maw was dodge. Wei dives to the back, and now Gala can open up the big guns. Infernum, the target, the possibility. Moonlight Vigil still available. No flashes really burnt on either side. Bean burns the heal, but there's the shutdown as Crying dives in, and the chase is on.
The chain!
The chain connects onto Ming, not onto Gala, who flashes away. Ming's going to jump away as well, and Fnatic continue their advance, continue to push forward. The bullet time coming in. Gala was hit with the hook, but Quibbo just cannot chase him down. Gala's still alive. Quibbo wants to stop watching the turn.
Oh,
in! Adam redeems himself from 1-8 to perhaps winning the game for Fnatic. They find the kill onto Gala that they needed to turn this
one
around.
They're going for more.
They're looking for more as the Realm Warp comes in. Xiao Hu able to dodge to the side. The Everfrost being used. No room prison available for Niski.
Yeah, Fnatic, I don't think they can end just yet. Xiao Hu still has ultimate. He can pop the ult on the wave. They have to go Nash. That's a miracle fight. And Fnatic, they have smite. They're burning this down. Bean has sunks.
They don't have the vision on him yet. There's the TP coming in. Fnatic, as you say, Bean has the flash. Explosive cast will knock him back. Xiao Hu going in, looking for Whippo. Smite available. Here comes Crying and Whippo able to secure the Baron. They also take down Xiao Hu.
Yeah, Xiao's dead.
Flash across. This is only soul for Fnatic. RNG would not get soul if this happens. Fnatic going to try and pull it out of the pit. don't really have vision on RNG.
The
way goes in. Adam secures it once again. There's a solo. Now they call that way. And they're going to burst it before he can get across with the safeguard. Beam with the stopwatch for himself. Everfrost short. The root comes out. Beam will fall with the round one now. Fnatic won this fight. But they're in a 3v4.
Adam on the flank.
Adam against the flank once again. Adam, you French genius, takes the kill. Fnatic find the fight.
They're going to do it.
Adam gets the
knock through this very durable Fnatic lineup. They have to be able to protect Gala, and Fnatic must get to him to take him down, but he's the only one that could do it.
Fnatic pushing into the base of RNG, looking to claim their first win of Worlds 2021, looking to continue the legacy that is Fnatic in week two. Baron buff has expired. They will take down the middle inhibitor. 6,000 gold, the difference between the teams, a Mountain Drake, a Mountain Soul, in fact, in Fnatic's pockets as well.
Yeah, Fnatic get the mid inhibitor, and they're gonna go towards bot now, push that in, there's no tier 2s up. Hilly's looking for a pick onto Ming.
There's a hook onto Ming, but he can jump in, and there's the Magnus Storm, and there's the chase, and Niski pops the stopwatch.
Bean has the angle.
Though, there's the stun, Bean has the angle for the bullet time. Hilly's like, kick back, knock back, the bullet time does not connect. Adam is not here with the team. I think Ryan tried to jump the wall and jump back there.
One
get across.
One for one.
Support for support.
Yeah, ultimates traded off as well. So no one really has any team fight available ultimates left, apart from Gala and Whippo. The siege still coming in, but RNG have wave clear. No Baron buff for Fnatic anymore. Oh, Whippo!
Stunned! Crying! Dead! Whippo! What can this man not do? He was top lane last world. He's jungle here. And once again, perhaps he's carrying Fnatic through this game.
Whippo is on fire today, catching Crying multiple times with the stun. They are pushing forward. It's going to be a second attempt.
Adam going in. They're looking for Gala, who flashes away. Adam knocked back. Being low as well, but the GAs are there. Adam pops into the GA. Whippo trying to trade us. Gala. Gala low. Whippo on a rampage. He steps up when they need him most. Fnatic's main man
this
is Whippo. The inhibitor down in the bottom lane of Fnatic, and now knocking on the Nexus towers. One tower and a Nexus between them.
RNG has nothing
left. A miraculous win. RNG can only watch as Fnatic tear through their base.
Oh, Fnatic, the dream.